girl shuddered at the thought of the dreadful possibilities. They started through a corridor and traversed it in silence a long way, glancing at each new opening to see if there was anything familiar about the look of it. But they were all strange. Every time Tom made an examination, Becky would watch his face for an encouraging sign, and he would say cheerily, "Oh, it's all right. This ain't the one, but we'll come to it right away." But he felt less and less hopeful with each failure, and presently began to turn off into diverging avenues at sheer random, in desperate hope of finding the one that was wanted. He still said it was all right, but there was such a leaden dread at his heart that the words had lost their ring and sounded just as if he had said, "All is lost." Becky clung to his side in an anguish of fear, and tried hard to keep back the tears, but they would come. At last she said, "Oh, Tom, never mind the bats. Let's go back that way. We seem to get worse and worse off all the time." Tom stopped. "Listen," said he. Profound silence. Silence so deep that even their breathings were conspicuous in the hush. Tom shouted. The call went echoing down the empty aisles and died out in the distance in a faint sound that resembled a ripple of mocking laughter. "Oh, don't do it again, Tom. It is too horrid," said Becky. "It is horrid, but I better, Becky. They might hear us, you know," and he shouted again. The "might" was even a chillier horror than the ghostly laughter. It so confessed a perishing hope. The children stood still and listened, but there was no result. Tom turned upon the back track at once and hurried his steps. It was but a little while before a certain indecision in his manner revealed another fearful fact to Becky. He could not find his way back.
"Oh, Tom, you didn't make any marks. Becky, I was such a fool, such a fool. I never thought we might want to come back. No, I can't find the way. It's all mixed up. Tom, Tom, we're lost. We're lost. We never can get out of this awful place. Oh, why did we ever leave the others?" She sank to the ground and burst into such a frenzy of crying that Tom was appalled with the idea.